Well, good morning, boys and girls. It's Uncle Aaron again, and thanks for joining me for today's Bible Zone video. Today, we're going to get started with a brand new action memory verse, followed by the Bible story time, and then we'll finish with the Bible Zone praise song. Are you ready to get started? Okay, here we go. Our action memory verse is from the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 1. And it says, "In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth." Now this verse is reminding us that God is the one who created everything. It didn't happen by accident. It was God who created and designed it all. So let's do it now with some actions. Are you ready? We're going to say, "In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth." Did you get that? Let's do it one more time. Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now it's time for our Bible story time. Let's see what happens in this week's video.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was formless and empty. Darkness covered the ocean, and the Spirit of God hovered over the surface of the water. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light.
God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and he called the darkness night. There was an evening, and there was a morning. That was the first day.
God separated the waters that were on the surface of the earth from the waters that were above the earth. He called the space above the earth sky. Evening came, and then the morning, and that was the second day.
God created dry land on the earth. He gathered the waters and called them seas. God commanded the earth to grow plants and trees. God saw that his creation was good. That was the third day.
Next, God put the lights in the sky, a sun to shine during the day and the moon and stars to shine at night. God saw that his creation was good. Evening came, and then the morning, and that was the fourth day.
God created sea creatures and birds. This creation was good too. God commanded them to multiply, to fill the seas and the earth. Evening came, and then morning. That was the fifth day. Then God created animals, like livestock and wildlife. God saw that his creation was good.
Finally, God said, "Let us make man in our image, according to our likeness." God created people differently from everything else he created. People were God's special creation because they were made in his image. God took dust from the ground and made a man.
God breathed his very own breath into the man, and the man became alive. God made a garden and put the man there. He grew trees to give food for the man, and he told the man to work in the garden and take care of it.
Then God said, "It is not good for a man to be alone. I will make a helper for him," God said. God caused the man to fall into a deep sleep. God took a rib from the man and created a woman to be the man's helper and wife. God named the man and woman Adam and Eve.
He blessed them and commanded them to multiply, fill the earth, and rule over creation. God saw all that he had made, and it was very good. Evening came, and then morning. That was the sixth day. Creation was complete. So God blessed the seventh day and declared it holy. On that seventh day, God rested.
By faith, we believe that God created the whole world by his word, Jesus. The Word of God is Lord over all creation. Everything was created by him and for him. The Son has always existed, and he holds everything together.
Boys and girls, before we start, I want to let you know that the Bible is God's Word. Yes, it was written by different people, but God is the one who, through his Holy Spirit, inspired them to write what they wrote. And so really, God ultimately was the one who wrote it. He just used people in order to produce it. So we can trust the Bible, we can know that it is true. And by reading our Bible, we get to know more about God and who He is and how He loves us, His plan for us, and how that plan includes sending Jesus to rescue us from our sins. The Bible also tells us how the world was created. Now, some people have different ideas about how supposedly this big explosion happened for no reason and out of nowhere, and suddenly all these things started to happen, and eventually, after millions and billions of years, everything that we see in the world today got here. But that doesn't make any sense, and we know that God is the one who created everything. He was behind it, He has existed forever, and He is the one that caused everything to exist. He created it through the power of His spoken word. God is our creator. He created the whole universe and everything in it. But He's not just our creator. He's also the king over everything. And the reason that He's the king over everything is because He rules. He has all of the power, all of the authority, and He made everything for His glory. What does that mean? That means that everything was created to show how great, how beautiful, how good, and how perfect God is. Now, we see that God also created people. He made us as male and female. Now, some people have different ideas about that as well, and some people have some confusion about that. Well, we shouldn't make fun of them, we shouldn't be mean to them, we should love them, but the truth is that God made us as males and females, and He knows what He's doing when He makes us, and He has a plan for each of our lives. Now, He made people to be different than all of the rest of creation. We are not just animals. He created us far above the animals. We should love and care for animals and be kind to them, but God made us special and different from the animals. We are different from the animals because we were made in God's image. And that means that we were made to know, love, and reflect God. Boys and girls, you might ask the question, how does creation show the greatness of God? That's a really good question. And I think that the more we look around the world, we can see how incredible it is, how complicated it is. The more that we learn and study science, the more we realize that this isn't simple. The things that God has done, the things that He has made, they're not simple. Many years ago, they thought that things were simple, but the more that we study and look into things and learn about God's creation, we actually can see how incredibly complicated everything is. But we can also see how perfectly it was designed. Even though the world is messed up because of sin and things aren't as perfect as they were when God first made them, we can still see that there was an amazing mind behind all of creation. We can see the complexity of life, which means how incredibly complicated and perfectly designed things are, and how things are made with a purpose, and how things work together and complement each other. And things like the distance of the earth from the sun. If the earth was a little bit further away, everything would be ice and nothing would be able to live here. It would be too cold. But if it was a little bit closer to the sun, things would burn up, it would be too hot, and we couldn't live here because of that. Everything is made perfectly, and God knew exactly what He was doing. So we can see the greatness of God the more that we study and look at His creation. I'd like to close with this question. Everything that God created was good. So what does this tell us about God? Well, boys and girls, it's time for our Bible's Own Praise Song. And since we've been learning how God is our creator, He's the one who created the universe and everything in it, and He's also the king over all the universe, I thought it would be great to do the song, Our Creator and King, because this reminds us of the truth, of the fact that God is the one who created everything. He's the one who controls everything, and He is our king. So let's think about that as we sing this song, Our Creator and King. Alright, boys and girls, I hope you liked that song and I hope you remember its message. Now, before we close in our prayer, I want to remind you, if you have any questions at all about anything you saw or heard today, or anything you might want to know about God or the Bible, I'd love to help answer those questions. So you can email me at the email address below, but make sure you get mom or dad's permission first. Let's pray to God. Dear God, I thank you that you are our creator and king. And God, I thank you that we didn't get here by accident, that you spent so much time thinking about how to make everything, and you did it all out of love, and you created us. You created people to be different from all of creation, and you have a plan and a purpose for all of our lives. God, I pray that we would grow to know you and grow to know that purpose and plan that you have for us. We ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Boys and girls, thank you so much for watching today's video. And remember, God is our creator and he's the king over everything. I'll see you next week.